Hi guys, this tutorial is aimed at teaching what a decision tree is. I have a very small problem in hand. I want to play tennis, but do I go out and play tennis or not depends on a lot of factors. Whether it's raining today, is it humid? If it's humid, it's very difficult to play. What do I do? Should I go out or not? Who will help me? This is where my decision tree would help me. Now, what is a decision tree? A decision tree is a supervised machine learning algorithm used for predicting outcomes based on certain rules and is done by partitioning the data into subsets. Don't be scared by whatever I've said. Don't worry, I'll explain each and everything as things come along. This is something that I've collected. On day one, it was sunny, it was really hot, it was humid, and it had a weak wind as well, so I didn't play tennis that day. On the other hand, when it was overcast, hot, normal, and a weak wind was blowing, I did play tennis that day. Now, today, the given date today, it's a very sunny day, it's a very cool temperature, it's very humid, and there is a strong wind blowing as well. Do I go out or not is what my 14 data points would help me identify. As you've already seen, the four attributes are outlook, humidity, wind, and temperature, and my target value is should I play tennis or not. Finally, this is how my decision tree should look like. But have you noticed something? Why is outlook first and then humidity and then wind? Why can't I first have humidity and then outlook and then wind? There's a reason for that. So the red boxes define the internal nodes. The blue boxes define the values of the internal nodes, and your leaf nodes are basically your final output target variables. Now there's something called as an entropy. The ordering of your nodes for the splitting criteria is based on entropy. Entropy is given a node, how homogeneous your samples are. By homogeneity, I mean if I have 20 samples and if I split it, whether those 20 are basically falling into one category left, yes, or do they fall into no. So it's either 20-0 or 0-20. Non-homogeneous is 10-10. If I make a split, if there are 50% yes and 50% no, that is when I say that it's not at all homogeneous. For such a case, the formula is minus p plus, that is positive, minus the positive samples, log to the base 2 positive samples. Again, add it with the negative samples. So this way you kind of have an entropy function. Now what the entropy does is it tells you how homogeneous your samples are. If your sample is really homogeneous, your value would be 0. If your samples are not homogeneous, your value of entropy would be 1. For making a split, the condition is known as information gain. Now information gain starts off by first calculating the entropy of your target variables. If you go back a bit, you'll realize I'll have 9 yeses and 5 noes. So in this play tennis column. So what I'll do next is I'll first calculate the entropy of my output variable, that is my play tennis. That turns out to be 0.94. In order for making a split, I have to have a very high information gain. So this is my training examples, as I've already showed you. Now selecting the first splitting attribute, I start with humidity. It has 9 positives and 5 negatives. Entropy at that point is 0.94, the way we started off. It splits as high and normal, which has 3 positives and 4 negative samples and 6 positive and 1 negative sample. The entropy at the individual points, calculating from those, that formula minus p log of p plus minus p negative log of p negative, you get 0.985. And for the normal samples, you get entropy as 0.592. The formula of gain is starting entropy minus the ratio of the entropy of that node into the ratio of the node value. So here you have 7 elements in the node. You started off with 14. So 7 by 14 into the entropy at that node. Again, negative of 7 nodes here, 7 by 14 divided into the value of my entropy, which is 0.592. You get 0.151. something similar is what you do for the wind variable, and you get 0.048, which is very low. And checking for the outlook variable, you start with 14 variables. You come here, you have 5, you have 4, and you have 5 again. So your gain here would be 0.940 minus 5 by 14 into 0.971 minus 4 by 14 into 0 and 5 by 14 into 0.971, which turns out to be 0.247. If you're wondering why is this 0.0, just see, it's a very homogeneous sample. It has either all positives, so it's a very homogeneous sample. So that is why your entropy at that node is 0.0. Once you have all the entropies in hand, the gain in hand, then the one with the maximum gain is the one that you use for your splitting criteria. And going ahead, I've also assumed 0 log to the base 2, 0 is 0. So coming here, I test for, now since the first node is ready, now I have to split based on the other nodes. At this node, I again check for the information gain. So again, I go back and do the same calculation for the remaining three conditions, humidity, temperature, and wind. And I find that again, the gain in humidity is maximum. So humidity comes here, and I'll go on and do this and grow the decision tree. Once a new testing data arrives, I just have to traverse the decision tree to reach to yes, no, whichever matches with the current criteria. I'll give that as my output. Hopefully you enjoyed the small introduction to how a decision tree works. Thank you.